I lead old Dan. I'm gone to Montana for to throw the hula hand. They feed in the gulch, they water in the draw. Their tails are all matted, their backs are all raw. Ride around, little dogies, ride around and slow. They're fiery and stuffy and raring to go. Whee! Old Buck Jones had a daughter and a son. His son went to Denver, but his daughter went wrong. His wife got killed in a bloody knife fight. Still he keeps singing from morning till night. Ride around, little dogies, ride around and slow. They're fiery and snuffy and raring to go. Whee!
It was summertime on the island of Sodor, and with the change in season, there came an influx of visitors. In fact, this particular year, the island was seeing record numbers of visitors, no thanks in part to the new television series. This in turn meant more passengers were riding on the railway, meaning extra coaches had to be added to the trains. Every engine struggled to cope, but no engine more so than Gordon with the Express. He found the loads very taxing, and he often needed a banker to get up his own hill. One particular evening, Gordon returned to the big station feeling very tired. The fat controller was waiting for him.
Gordon, you have done an excellent job managing your trains the past few weeks, despite the extra load. However, it's clear to me that this has taken quite the toll on you, so I'll be sending you to the works to have your worn parts mended.
Thank you, sir, but who will look after the express while I'm gone?
Let me see now. Henry can't do it since he's all booked up at the moment, but I think James is available for the time being.
And with that, the Fat Controller walked thoughtfully away. The next day, the Fat Controller came to see James, who, as one would expect, was delighted to hear about his job.
Of course, sir. My red paint is sure to dazzle the crowd.
Yes, well, you will need some help with the...
But James' arrogance and ego was too inflated to listen. A bit later, James proudly backed down onto the express, feeling quite confident and cocky. He was so busy basking in the glory that he didn't notice Thomas backing onto the train in front of him.
Thomas, get out of my way. This is my train.
Don't you mean our train?
This is my train.
Weren't you listening to the Fat Controller this morning, James? Because of the extra load, another engine was needed to assist, and I was the only one available.
James said nothing. Instead, he grumbled to himself as he waited to depart. Soon enough, the guard blew his whistle, and slowly but surely, the Wild Nor'wester was coming. Soon, the two engines were barreling down the main line. James snorted in frustration as they sped along the line. Nobody seemed to pay attention to him. Instead, they were more focused on Thomas. They thought the idea of a tank engine pulling the express was a grand one, and one person even called it the Thomas Nor'wester.
Why does Thomas get everything? Well, I don't even get a hello.
James grumbled to himself. His driver laughed.
Well, it's quite a spectacle seeing a little tank engine at the head of a train like this. If Thomas had to pull the train all on his own, he wouldn't be able to get up Gordon's Hill.
This gave James a sneaky idea.
If Thomas isn't able to get the train up Gordon's Hill, then everybody will realize I'm doing all the real work.
So gradually, James reduced his steam, though he was practically rolling along with the rest of the train. Gradually, Thomas felt the coaches get heavier and heavier until he was practically struggling. James grinned smugly as poor Thomas fought to keep the train going. James' driver tried desperately to turn the regulator back on, but try as he might, he couldn't get it to reopen. Soon, the train arrived at Gordon's Hill. Thomas struggled up the grade with all his might, but it was no use. Thomas came to a standstill right in the middle of the hill.
Well, that's torn it,
said Thomas Shriver.
Looks like we're going to need a banker after all.
Carefully, Thomas rolled back down to the bottom of the hill in order to wait for Edward to come and bank the train. As they were waiting, James Shriver spoke to Thomas Shriver about what happened.
So, I attempted to reopen the regulator,
he said,
but I think it's jammed. Do you think Thomas will be able to get the train to the end of the line on his own? I'm not sure,
replied Thomas Shriver,
but we can sure as heck try.
Soon Edward arrived.
Beep, beep. Are you ready?
He called.
Beep, beep, beep. Yes, I am,
Thomas replied. The two engines struggled up Gordon's Hill.
Come on! Come on!
Snorted Thomas.
We'll do it! We'll do it!
Replied Edward.
Come on!
We'll do it!
Come on!
We'll do it!
They puffed together. It was hard work, but eventually with one last mighty heave, Thomas got the express over the hill.
We've done it! We've done it!
He panted. It was going to be hard work to get the train all the way to Vickerstown, so it was decided that the train could stop at Croven's Gate, where another engine would take over the train and pull it to Vickerstown. At last, Thomas, tired yet triumphant, pulled into the workstation. The Fat Controller was waiting impatiently for them, and he was not pleased.
Thomas and James, why are you so late?
James' crew stepped out of the cab and explained the situation. He was most appalled by what he heard.
James, I cannot believe what you've just done. I would have thought you would have known better than to pull a stunt like this. As soon as your regulator's mended, you'll be returning to your shed until I can figure out what to do with you.
James gulped. He then turned to Thomas, and then smiled.
As for you, Thomas, I must say I'm very impressed. Despite the cams being stacked against you, you pulled through and got the train to its station. As a reward for your hard work, you'll receive a complete overhaul and a new coat of paint.
Oh, sir! Thank you, sir!
And with that, the two engines were uncoupled from the train, and Henry came to take the train to the end of the line. Thomas ran promptly to the works, while James was shunted to a siding out of the way. As soon as his regulator was mended, James rolled home tender first. People did notice it this time. But instead of cheering and waving, the people just glared and jeered at James. Poor James felt most uncomfortable. But I think he deserved it, don't you?
Racing the wind, chasing the sun, heading for town. Roundup is done, hooves on the fly, dead on the run. Throw my lasso around the west wind and ride on chasing the sun. It's been a long, long ride on a long, long trail, and now my work is over. Too many nights with the coyote's wail, now it's home call for this rover. I know my sweetheart waits for me on a sunny mountainside. But now payday has come for my pony and me, and so it's ride, ride, ride. Racing the wind, chasing the sun, heading for town. Roundup is done, hooves on the fly, dead on the run. Throw my lasso around the west wind and ride on chasing the sun.
Every time they ask me why, I just smile and say, you've got to kiss an angel good morning and let her know you think about her when you're gone. Kiss an angel good morning and love her like the devil when you get back home.